Hello and welcome to a special soundbite edition of the Physio Matters Podcast, brought to you by IFOMPT 2016. The second of our seven keynote speakers, Annina Schmid, is on our microphones today. Listen up at the end to find out how to get the extended interview. So let's get to it. Hi, Dr. Schmid. Would you like to introduce yourself for the listeners?
My name is Annina Schmid. I guess many people also know me as Nina, and I'm a research fellow currently at Oxford University at the Nuffield Department of Clinical Neurosciences. My main research focuses on the pathophysiology of neuropathic pain and entrapment neuropathies in particular. But although I'm kind of doing full-time research at the moment, I would say I'm a musculoskeletal physiotherapist at heart. And I'm still practicing half a day per week to keep that going.
I see. And tell me a little bit about your CV historically then. Where have you come from?
Yeah. Well, my journey is probably a bit unusual and sometimes probably a bit surprised myself where it's taking me. I graduated as a physiotherapist in Switzerland. That was in 2001. And I then started work as a musculoskeletal therapist at the local university hospital in Zurich. And I decided very early on that I really wanted to become specialized in musculoskeletal therapy. And in 2005, I would say I not only saved enough money, but I was also lucky to be admitted at Curtin University in Perth at the local musculoskeletal master's program there. And I spent an incredible year there in Perth, obviously surrounded by an amazing international bunch of motivated physiotherapists. I guess there were many up and downs there during the course, but the Australian way of life and occasional barbecue kept us going.
Of course.
After that year in Australia, I returned to Switzerland and went back to work at the University Hospital again in Zurich. And I was very lucky to have been offered a position as a clinical specialist, but with a 40% research component on top of it. And it was during that time that I started my research into neurodynamics and the mechanisms of manual therapy-induced analgesia. But very soon I kind of noticed that I would like to concentrate a bit more on research. But doing a PhD in Switzerland was difficult. Actually, at the time, it was impossible as a physiotherapist because I graduated with a diploma and I didn't have an actual undergrad university degree.
I see.
So I decided to return back to Australia, and I was lucky enough, I would say, to get some fellowships, which allowed me to start my PhD. That was that time under the supervision of Michelle Kopitis, Elspeth McLachlan, Paul Hodges and Mark Rautenberg at the University of Queensland in Brisbane. And I did my PhD with a project that was entitled Implications of Mild Peripheral Nerve Compressions Beyond the Lesion Site, Mechanisms and Interventions.
That then is probably your maybe best known work in terms of that area. Your journey as a researcher has been linked to and seemingly inspired by your journey as a clinician. But what would you say has led to the special interest in neuropathic pain and being known for that?
Yeah, there are probably several different reasons why I'm doing my research specifically in neuropathic pain and entrapment neuropathies. Now, as I mentioned, I was working as a clinician at the local university hospital in Zurich, and as part of this job, I was seeing many patients with neural involvement and neuropathic pain, including, of course, a lot of patients with radiculopathies or peripheral entrapment neuropathies. What I found very confusing when seeing these patients, especially when I was a new graduate, was that very often they reported symptoms in locations that did anatomically at least not make sense to me. You know how, you know, we learn in textbooks that quite often radiculopathies should actually present with a dermatomal pattern,
of course, the peripheral nerve
injury should lead to symptoms in the peripheral innervation territory.
Wishful thinking, I suppose.
Exactly. So what I realized is that when I completed a body chart with these patients is that almost never I found a nice dermatomal or peripheral nerve innervation zone. And patients actually had pain in completely anatomically unrelated areas. Mm-hmm. So I thought either these patients do not have a radiculopathy or an entrapment neuropathy after all, or the textbooks might actually not be right. And that is one reason that got me into research. on this condition.
Okay, so it was a clinical head scratcher that then made you delve into things in an academic sense. Very, very interesting. And your presence as a keynote speaker at IFOMPT 2016 will no doubt interest potential delegates that we're trying to inspire. Was your invitation an easy one to accept? And why would you say that conferences such as this are important?
Yeah, I mean, that is not difficult to answer. I guess it was obviously an honor when I received that email. And I can remember I actually had to read through twice to actually believe that I was invited. I mean, IFOMPT is a very important association that brings together specialist musculoskeletal therapists from all over the world. I personally believe these conferences are very, very important for several reasons.
Believe it or not, this interview gets better. If you want to hear the extended version, log on to ifomptconference.org and register your interest for what is promising to be a brilliant event. We're supporting IFOMPT 2016 in Glasgow because physio matters.